Hey guys, it's Ileane from basicblogtips.com. Today I want to talk about Tailwind app. And Tailwind app works to analyze your activity on Pinterest. It's going to show you the best times to pin, who your top pinners are, and so much more. So let's go over to the dashboard and check it out. Now, before we head over to the Tailwind app dashboard, I want to give you guys a little insight. Over in Google Analytics, you can see why I am so interested in Pinterest now. Check this out in your Google Analytics account. Go over to Acquisition and under Social, look at Network Referrals. And this is going to tell you all those social networks and how valuable that traffic is on your blog. For example, I have Facebook. I get a lot of page views and people stay for about a minute. If you come down here to Pinterest, notice Pinterest is right behind YouTube, which is fabulous because I know that YouTube is one of my best traffic sources. So when I look at Pinterest, I see that the people that are coming from Pinterest are visiting multiple pages. And they're staying a really long time. They're staying even longer than the people from YouTube. And that's primarily because the people from YouTube have probably already watched some of my videos while they were on YouTube. But these people are just watching videos and going through my content on a very detailed level. So you check out your Pinterest traffic sources in those social reports on Google Analytics. But Google Analytics doesn't tell you all the fantastic things that the Tailwind app is going to show you. So now let's go over to Tailwind app and check it out. And here we are over on the Tailwind dashboard. Now, before we go any further, I want to give a shout out to Cynthia Sanchez from Oh So Pinteresting. She's the one who really got my interest sparked into finding out the possibilities of what I could do with Pinterest. So she's got a podcast, so check it out. It's the Oh So Pinteresting podcast. So here we have right on our main dashboard area. I'm going to scoot over so you can see a little bit more of the reports here. You're going to see fantastic information right on this dashboard about the followers, about the numbers of pins you have, your repins, which is really important because most of the traffic that you're going to be getting from Pinterest is going to come from repins. So repins are really important. And of course, likes. And you can see that I've been paying a lot more attention to Pinterest, and Pinterest has been paying my blog a lot more attention too. So let's move down to the report that's called Your Website. And you'll see here it's showing you the trending pins from my blog. It's showing the total pins for the last 7 days, which I think this is fabulous that there's been that many pins just in 7 days. And you can see all the different items that have been pinned. And if I click on total unique pinners, now you're getting some really valuable information because you're finding out about the people who are on Pinterest that are interested in what's going on your blog. Now let's move down to trending pins. This is another report. Once again, you're getting the opportunity to see who are these pinners, these people that are engaging with your content. You're also finding out what they're saying when they pin. You get a little tag board over here. But what if you want to know who the top pinners are? Here you can see the people that are pinning the most. What about the top repinners? There you go. And then This is where you get to increase your engagement. It's telling you that this person, her name's Kara, she's not following you, she's engaging with your content, but now this gives me opportunity to go over to her boards and start engaging with her. And there's my friend, Cynthia Sanchez from Oso Pinteresting. I'm going to be engaging with her, that's for sure. Jeff and Wade, they recently did a Google Hangout on Air about the men of Pinterest. So I'm glad to see that they are some of my top repinners. Now, what about influential followers? That's another report here. Who are those influential followers that we have? Who are the top brand promoters? You know, some of these faces are going to be familiar to you and some of them aren't. So go and engage with those people. And the link is right there to get you to easily engage with folks. Next, let's look at the peak days and times. Now, this is going to help you optimize your content and when you're doing your pinning. You'll see what are the best days to pin. You'll see the best times to pin. In other words, if I pin on Thursdays at 6 p.m., there's a great chance, well, actually a 350% chance that I'm going to get repins. So since that's a convenient time for me, there's no reason why I can't make sure that on Thursdays at around 6 p.m., I'm doing some pinning from my own blog and some other fantastic content that I'm seeing out there on the web. Well, here we are over at my Pinterest boards. And I just really want to encourage you, come over, check out some of what I'm pinning here. I've got blogging tips. I'm using the new feature of Pinterest for maps, and I'm doing the local Philly meetups and tech events. And most of these are my own personal pictures. Make sure you integrate some of your own personal pictures into your Pinterest boards as well. Make sure you put your top Pinterest boards up here in the top row. Here I've got the YouTube tips, podcasting, and another board that I have that's very popular. Actually, this is a group board I have with my daughter, which is fashion and style. And of course, this board is getting a lot of activity as well. There she is. There's my daughter. There are some more things you can do over here with the Tailwind app. Start exploring, optimize your pins, make sure that you're pinning other people's content and repinning, engaging on Pinterest, and you can build some great targeted traffic back to your blog from Pinterest. Okay, I'll talk to you guys soon. Once again, it's Ileane from Basic Blog Tips. Happy pinning!